Hi, this is Cher from Cher's Crafting Boutique. I came across these smellies for your wardrobe, drawer, suitcase. All different kinds of uses. And they came in a pack of two. And they had this ribbon on. Got them from my local DIY shop. You can pick these up anywhere really, but I thought these were perfect for me to put a shabby chic like sock over the top that you can reuse. So then obviously because it's a pack of two, you can just slip it off and put the new one in. So I haven't done this yet, so I'm doing this completely on camera. So this is what I have. Obviously I have the smellies. So one of these, and I've took the ribbon off, as I said. I've got that scrap piece of lace off of a netting that I used in my previous video. I also have these scrap pieces of fabric that I've had a look and they fit pretty well. I've just put a hole in them at the top there. I also have this ribbon. It's a bit like of a, I wouldn't say, it's more of a lace, but has ribbon on, so got that. I've also got this ribbon ballerinas on, but again you can use whatever you have. I have this lace, it's more stiff kind, but again whatever you have will be fine. Some pink roses and some feathers. This is called a craft marabou boa. Now I've got this from the range. I don't know if I'm going to use that yet, but I also had these flowers that I made, which I showed you. That's why I tell you to keep all of your stems. I showed you this in a previous video and I'm going to use these on this project. So I'm going to move all this out of the way so we can get started. So, made this lace as well. And here we are. I'm going to start off with this. So I'm moving that out the way as well. So what I want to do is start by bending these back and hot gluing them down. Just hold that down there. Same on the other side. You don't have to do this bit, this is just the way I think they will look better, but that, if you like them the other way, that's fine. Now I'm going to make sure this lines up with the hole. Get away with that piece there. Underneath there. Then all I'm going to do is the same here, make sure it lines up with the hole. Keep it all in place. Now I think I'm going to grab one of my clips just to be safe. Just a second. Just so it don't move whilst we're doing this. So I'm just going to clip that to there, so we know it's not going to move. Right, now all I'm going to do here is I'm not going to take it right up against here because we want it to have some movement and also it could end up getting caught with the hot glue. So all I'm going to do is make sure it comes out quite a bit, just down here. So I've got these little notches on mine, so I'm going to go to the second one just on the outer side here. And glue it down there. If you don't have that, then just like I said, make sure you've got a decent amount of gap so you can slide it in and out afterwards so it's reusable. I'm just going to take the hot glue all the way down there. Just As I say to you all the time, if you don't have the same as me, that doesn't mean you can't do this. You use whatever you have. Whatever fabric you have, whatever lace you have, it will all work. Just get them out and be creative. Now what I'm going to do is the same thing here. So again, I'm just going to take it along here. I'm leaving a bit of a gap, but not much of a one this time, because I don't want it to slide down. Because if I leave too much of a gap at the bottom, what will happen is this will slide further down once I take the clip off, and we don't want that. So I'm just going to make it that little bit higher up this time. You'll see mine has this backing, this plastic backing. And the reason why mine has this is because I have a local store. This, once they're finished with the books, they sell them with examples in. So I get mine that way. As well as also buying them anyway. I do buy my own fabrics in meters, but when the books are there, I like to get the bits and pieces so I can have smaller pieces for projects. So that's why that's on there. But again, we're going to leave this gap. So on here, I've got three notches, so I'm going to count mine along. One, two, three, and then do it. But you, like I said, if you don't have this, don't worry about it. It doesn't matter. Just use what you have. It doesn't have to be perfect. As you can see, mine's gone off there, so I'm just going to slide that back up. And I'm just gluing that down till I get to the bottom again. You hear the dog there, she's whining on because she wants out of her room. There we are. My son's going to let her out of there now. She whines on to be in there, and then within minutes later she wants straight back out again. Right. So now I'm just going to see that's all secure actually before I go ahead. Yes, that is. So I'm just going to cut that down there, take off all that excess. So as I said to you, don't worry if it's not perfect, we're not aiming for perfection. I'm just cutting off the excess. Make sure it's all still secure. Which is a little bit there that needs a little more glue. Now all I'm going to do, I'm going to take that off there now. And that sits there lovely. And there's a little bit more I can take off the edge there, so I'm going to do that. There we are, that's what we have so far. And as you can see, that comes out, pops back in, no problem there. Get these out of the way. Right. So I no longer need that anymore, so I'm moving that out of the way, because I have such small space on this table. Right, now we're going to get the lace. Which, like I said, this is netting. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to, let's have a look, turn this over, yeah, I'm going to bring it below the hole there, like so. So all I'm going to do now is take my hot glue, and it's being a pain because it's over hot, and I'm just going to run a thin amount glue there in a line all the way to the other side and secure that down there. And I'm going to do that along the edge here all the way to the bottom, secure that down. Take it along the bottom edge here, move that to one side slightly, so you can see all I'm doing is a very thin amount of glue all the way along and securing that down. The same with this edge here. Now I'm going to get my scissors, and while I can see it, I'm just going to cut that excess off. Both sides there. Then I'm going to run the glue along this bottom edge here, very thin amount, and then just flip that over and pull it tight. Just secure that down. Do the same with this side. Again, we're not taking it to the top, we're just taking it to just under where the hoop is. Along from one side to the other and securing that down. And then just along this edge here, all the way along, and secure that. We are. Now, I'm going to take a little bit more here because it's not straight very well there. There we are. Now I'm going to cut this excess off here. Well, actually, I think I might just fold this side because this is the opposite side and I think that looks quite nice along there. So I'm going to fold mine. So I'm just going to put a little bit of glue along there, another straight line from one side to the other. Well, it doesn't have to be straight, but as nice as you can get it, as neat as you can get it, really is what I should have said, all the way along, taking the excess off, flip it over and do the same on the opposite side. Do away with all that excess there. And this is what I have so far. And I think it's looking very pretty. Coming together nicely. Now I am going to take... No, I'm going to start at the top and work my way down. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to glue that along that upper edge there. So I'm just hot gluing again, thin line, all the way along to secure it. and popping that down on there. Taking the ends off there. Now I'm going to take it down further on this side. Don't know where that's got a mark on, so I'll take that off. Don't want that on there. And I am going to glue that along there. So we're just going to take it across that edge there that I folded and sticking this down here, just to make the back look rather pretty too. A little bit more across there because I didn't secure it properly there. Get my scissors. These are smaller ones, I think. And just cut those edges there. Now, that's what we have so far. Now I have, as I said, this ribbon, which I have a lot of it, so I want to incorporate that into this. But I don't know whether I should. We need something, I think, for this edging. Have a look. No, we definitely need something for this edging, I think. So, let's see. Yes, I think I'm going to put this either side. Yeah. So I'm going to put some hot glue down the edge here. And secure this to here. Like so. And then I'm just going to fold this in on the corner. I'm just going to put a little bit of glue there and then fold it. And then another little bit of glue and fold it again to get around that corner there. And then that little bit more, just there. And then fold it again. And there we are. I'll make that stay flat. And just again glue around that edging on the bottom there. Secure that down. Leave this ribbon for a second. And we're going to do the same thing, we're just folding it on an angle, like so. A little bit at a time, popping a tiny amount of glue there, securing that down, and again folding, again just a small amount on an angle, popping some glue underneath, very small amount, and secure it down. And then again, do as straight as possible up here, hot glue to the top. excess. Now I'm going to just cut that on an angle slightly downwards. It gives it more of a nicer edge there. And now they're both looking roughly the same on both sides. Now, as I was saying, I'm thinking about putting this on here through the middle there. Yeah, so I'm just going to take a line of glue, very thin amount, all the way along the middle there, roughly. It doesn't have to be completely spot on, but just down the middle. And I'm just going to trim that excess. Same on both sides. And then I'm going to make a rough bow. So I'm just making two hoops. Now, do I want that bow? Or do I want to use this? You know what, I think I'll do a bit of both. So I'm going to just get my thread. Just a second there. And here we are. So I'm just going to roughly cut that the same on both sides. Get my thread. Now this is how I do mine. You could do yours any way that you think is best by you. Just go off screen there to just get that thread. And all I'm doing is putting some, grabbing the end of it into the middle there and holding it down with my thumb. And just wrapping, once I get a hold of it, 2 seconds. That slipped. Probably hear the washer going there. It's quite loud. I don't know why it's doing that lately. Keep spinning that round. Cut the excess off there. All I'm going to do is get some hot glue. Just a little bit into the middle. Find roughly the centre. And then I'm going to get some of this. I'm not going to make this as big of a one, and I'm not going to add on the little bits at the end here. So I am just going to go on a rough guide here. I don't like measuring, so you do what's best by yourself. And I've wrapped it about 4 or 5 times there, just to make it a bit thicker. And then I'm just going to cut it along there. Grab the rest of that thread that I had out there. I'm just going to literally pinch it together in the middle here. Grab the thread in the middle and just wrap it again. So all we're doing, wrapping it round. And just cut off that excess. Bring this closer. Tiny dab of glue in the middle there. And just stick that there. Right, I need my lighter just to secure these edges, because I do not want them to fray. These would be brilliant as little gifts for people. I know in America it's supposed to be coming up for Mother's Day. We've had ours. And I've got lots of crafting gifts for mine. Right, and all I did there was just secure it down just to make sure these edges don't fray. You only need it slightly go across the edge there. Now I have these, like I said, that I made in a previous video. So if you haven't seen it, please do check it out. Just take them out of that tub there. Move that out the way so you can see. And do away with these, this ribbon. Right, so yes, these I made in a previous video. So please do go check that out if you don't know and you haven't seen it. So I have them at the ready and I'm going to get these pink roses. I don't know how many I'm going to use, so I'm just going to grab three. And what I'm going to do is pop these behind there like that. So I'm literally just lifting the bow up. And I'm going to put a little bit of glue, just a little dab of it. You don't need a lot for this. And I'm just going to stick that behind there. I'm going to do the same the opposite side. Little dab of glue. And just stick that down there. Like so. I'm going to see if I can get somewhere in. Yes, I can. Behind the ribbon, I'm going to cut that a little bit so it ends up roughly the same size. And I'm just going to head behind the ribbon here. A tiny bit of glue there. And then just stick that behind there. Secure that down. And then I'm getting these roses, cutting the stems off. Again, remember to keep them. First of all, I'm going to stick one direct in the middle there. Hold that down for a second. And then I'm going to stick one here, just between those two flowers at the back here. And I'm going to do the same here. There's someone at the door there. Do you mind getting it for me, please? Thank you. And there we are. That's what we have. And then all I'm going to do now, move them out of the way, is put, thank you, this ribbon back through there. Now I'm thinking, to make it easier to go through, I'm going to cut these edges off because they're a little bit frayed. Grab the lighter. Just run that through. And what I'm gonna do is just cut some of this tulle and then wrap it round. And then again, just accordion, pinch it in the middle. So I'm going to keep hold of that and push this through there. Now this could be a bit fiddly, but we'll get there. So turn that over, pull it through. Now I'm going to put this into there. It's just going to sit there. We're not going to do any hot gluing because it will stop it from being taken out. And all I'm going to do is take that through there and pull. Like so. And there you have it. So now you have a lovely place to, you could hang it in your room, you could hang it in your wardrobe, put it in your suitcase, and it'll look just nice wherever you put it instead of you having to hide it away because it doesn't look very nice. Now you have the opportunity to reuse it, and I think it just looks lovely. So thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. I now have a Facebook page, it's called Shirz Crafting Boutique. Place to put all your pictures of everything that you make to inspire other people. Please do check it out. Thank you. Bye.